exactly like it's printed in the bulletin. Everybody thinks it's different, so just sing.
Others. It wasn't okay. Oh, you're welcome. All right. We had lots and lots of fun this week. We learned all about how God provides food for us, as well as other things. So today, we want to share with you guys kind of what we did all week. All right? So, we're going to start by standing up, because that's what we started every morning. We stood up, and we had a little food truck party going on, didn't we? All right. How about all you kids come on up here? You guys can show us how you dance. He'd be right down here in front. Come on, everybody. Yeah, we have so much fun. You ready, Madison? Hit it. Ready?
It seemed like every day somebody was in need of God's help. And a lot of times it was they didn't have enough food to eat.
Oh, and so we're saying God maybe didn't provide for them?
He provided for them in the desert.
Nice.
And on the waters, and with the 5,000 people he fed.
Yeah.
And everyone was pleased and bowed down to God because they all needed his help. And
that's
he
correct.
Came through they with all, some miracles.
They all knew it was God, didn't they?
Yes.
By the end of it, they knew it was him. All right. Now, we're going to sing one song that has to do with one of those miracles, aren't we?
Can I say one more thing, Wendy?
What?
I just wanted to wish Nolan a happy birthday from DJ Cupcake.
Happy birthday, Nolan, from DJ Cupcake. And Elijah's birthday's on Friday.
Happy birthday, Friday, Elijah!
There we go. Nice. All right, you guys come on up. Everybody on your feet. We're going to do Manna.
And Bible story.
You can't forget Bible story.
Our Father in heaven,
our Father in heaven,
how awesome is your name,
how awesome is your name.
Your kingdom come, your will be done,
your kingdom come, your will be done,
on earth as in heaven,
on earth as in heaven.
Give us this day our daily bread,
give us this day our daily bread.
Forgive our sins as we forgive,
forgive our sins as we forgive.
Lead us not into temptation,
but deliver us from evil.
Yours is the kingdom
forever and ever.
Yours is the power
forever and ever.
Yours is the glory
forever and ever.
Forever and ever and ever. Amen.
Our Father in heaven,
our Father in heaven,
how awesome is your name,
awesome is your name.
Your kingdom come, your will be done.
Your kingdom come, your will be done.
On earth as in heaven.
On earth as in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread.
Give us this day our daily bread.
Forgive our sins as we forgive.
Forgive our sins as we forgive.
Lead us not into temptation.
Lead us not into temptation.
But deliver us from evil.
Deliver us.
For yours is the kingdom. Sins as we forgive,
forgive our sins as we forgive.
Lead us not into temptation,
not into temptation.
But deliver us from evil.
Obedience is the good stuff.
John, we went to chapter 21, verses 5 and 6. He called out to them, "Friends, haven't you any fish?" "No," they answered. So he said, "Throw your net on the right side of the boat and you will find some." When they did, they were unable to haul the net in because of the large number of fish. This is the word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Let's pray. God is good. God is great. Let us thank God for our food. By God's hands we all are fed. Give us, Lord, our daily bread. Amen.
Amen.
That's really short and simple and sweet, and I did it backwards. It's God is great, God is good. And it was written down right here, so. Yeah. But it's really short and sweet, and we've probably said it 1,000 times before we ate. And maybe we didn't really understand that it does go deeper than just short and sweet. And in VBS, we learned just that this week. So, God is great. Moses and Aaron led the Israelites out of Egypt, and they were there for 400 years, and that's a long time to be there. But they finally got through the plagues, and they finally got through the Red Sea, and they got into the desert, and they were there about a month and a half. And they started grumbling. "We don't have any food, Moses. Where's our food, Aaron? You know, we could have had all this food in Egypt. We had our meat pots, and we could have had all kinds of food and water, and here we are languishing in the desert." And God heard their cries. So God said to Moses, "Tell them that I will feed them, and I will bring quail at night, and I will bring manna in the morning." So the Israelites would go out in the morning, and the dew, once it dried, was this little flecks of white. They looked like colored coriander, maybe, and kind of smelled like honey, tasted like honey. And they were all over, but just over where the Israelites were. I think if they had gone further, there wouldn't have been any out there. It was just over where the Israelites were. So, and they were to pick as much as they needed for that day. Take as much as you need. And then when the quail came in, God said, "Take as much as you need, but do not keep it for tomorrow. Tomorrow, it won't be any good." And God used this as a test. It says it in the scripture. He tested the Israelites to see if they believed him. Well, most of them did, but a few tried to save it. And because they tried to save it, it was stinky and full of maggots, and it wasn't good. And of course, Moses got angry, because Moses got angry about a lot of things. But the next day, they went out. There was the manna again. And God did this every day with the manna and the quail for 40 years. Every day, collect what you need for that day. There was one exception, and the exception to that was the day before the Sabbath. Collect what you need for today and tomorrow. Because the Sabbath, he didn't want them to work. Well, of and she did it. And when she brought it to him, and she gave Elijah the bread, he promised her that the Lord would not let her flour and her oil decrease until the drought had passed. And he stayed with her until the drought passed, and God did just that. They had enough oil and enough flour to keep them alive. So when we say God is good, that means he cares for us. And when we pray this, we are reminded that God loves us and wants us to share good things that we have received from him. Let us thank God for our food. Now, to make a long story short, this is Daniel 1. Daniel 1 talks about Daniel and his three friends that were captured by the army of King Nebuchadnezzar of Babylon, and they threw them in prison. Now, they only wanted the best of the best, and Daniel and his three friends were right at the top of that list. So while they were in prison and learning how to serve the king, they were offered the finest food and wines that from the king's table. But Daniel and his friends didn't want to eat that. They didn't want to defile their bodies in that way, so they asked the official, could you please give us fruits and vegetables and water to drink? And he said, oh, I don't know. That doesn't sound like I should do that, because what if you guys are weaker? And, you know, he said, I'll tell you what, 10 days, give us 10 days. And if we're not better, stronger, take it away. So God caused him to say, okay, we'll do that for 10 days. And after those 10 days, those guys were in immaculate condition. I mean, I guess, you know, a night of eating heavy food and drinking a lot of wine, the next day you're probably not going to be at your best right away. So when the official figured this out, he gave them all fruits and vegetables and water. Now this is how they honored God, by treating their bodies kindly. As the Bible tells us, God gave knowledge, mastery of all literature and wisdom to these four men. And Daniel gained understanding of every vision and dream. That's in Daniel 1:17. And a side note, those three men that were with Daniel were none other than Shadrach, Meshach, and Abednego. We know what happens to them. So when we say, let us thank God for our food, we are reminded that no matter where our food comes from or who helps us receive our food, we should all remember that what we have to eat is ultimately a gift from God. So let us eat with a thankful heart. By God's hands, we all are fed. This is from John chapter 6, verses 1 through 13. And in this passage, the miracle of feeding the 5,000 begins with Jesus and his disciples going off and finding some solitude. However, when Jesus looked out, there was a whole bunch of people following him. got a fire already, there's bread. Jesus says, bring me some fish from your load. So he cooks them fish and bread, and he feeds them like the 5,000. And after they ate, Jesus asked Peter three times, do you love me? And three times Peter says, yes, you know that I love you. And three times Jesus answers, feed my lambs, tend my sheep, feed my sheep. But why three times? Why ask, do you love me, Peter, three times? Well, I think that this probably correlates to Peter
Thank you.